Good afternoon.
On m'a demandé de vous venir vous parler
I was told to talk about conquest.
Et BPI a ajouté quelque chose en disant
And BPI added something. They told me we would like you to talk about conquest
Alors,
but also to talk about yourself.
Me plier à l'exercice.
So that's what I will do.
And de ce qui fait mon imaginaire personnel.
I will talk about my personal belief. Don't worry, I won't be talking about my hopes and desires because I'm not sure it would be interesting. But as an actor of innovation, my past is what I am and what I do.
Ça se voit, vous me direz.
So that's what I will be talking about.
Mon père est coréen, moi je suis français.
My father is Korean. You will tell me that it's obvious, but I can't see it. My mother is French, and I am 100% French. I'm so French that, to be honest, when I look at myself in the mirror, I can't see my eyes that are Asian, for example, that look Asian. And this tells a lot about French integration. And by the way, I have a second name, Maltec.
The
minister for the digital is called Cédric Yantec.
Bref.
So,
pourquoi je vous dis
yeah,
ça? C'est
it's like my second name, my middle name.
So,
why am I saying that? Well, because I'm French. But I know Asia, I know South Korea. And this obviously has an impact on the way I see the Korean society on one hand and the French society on the other hand. In 1960, Korea was the poorest country in the world. In the 1960s, it has the smallest GDP in the world behind Ghana. My father often told me the history of my family. They were aristocratic family in North Korea. They fled during the war. And they ended up in South Korea. The last hunger in South Korea was in 1960. And now Korea is the 11th biggest economy in the world. The GDP is bigger than Spain's GDP. In technology, it is a leader. It has 5G. It is a leader in battery, much more than Europe. Why am I saying that? Well, because Korea multiplied its GDP 200-fold in 50 years. And the history of Korea is a history of conquest. It is enshrined in the society's DNA. The society is based on work, on devotion. France as well. And if you think of the reason why we are all here, the reason why France is such a prosperous country, it's because in France there were two main periods of innovation. There was the 19th century, Clément Ader, Louis Peugeot, Louis Blériot, Marie Curie. They decided to take risks, to manipulate radioactivity and to die for it. Because these men and women took risks, because they decided to become entrepreneurs, because we had in the 1960s a new wave of innovation with the railway, with nuclear, that we are here today. The history of France is intertwined with the history of its researchers, of its innovators, all those who took risks and who innovated. And we are now in the midst of a third industrial revolution, as it was said this morning.
And
by renewing the French innovation, by the French tech, we are trying to be true to our history. But the French mindset is very diverse. France is it is enlightenment and those who have very dire way of thinking. It is those who are open-minded and those who are scared of everything. And France's history is made of light and darkest moments. It is made out of fight, of struggles, of those who are against vaccines, against abortion, and so on. France is divided between progress and science and those who are against. And today, what we are doing is supporting technology, obviously, supporting job creation, but it's also a democratic economic struggle, a fight. To know which part of French society will prevail over the other. The General de Gaulle, in his Mémoires de Guerre, said something very interesting. In 1940, he said, regardless of the difficulties, and there were many difficulties with the occupation of France, the Third Reich, he said that despite these difficulties, you cannot overcome obstacles without dreaming, without thinking of the future. And France is about a common legacy, a common heritage. France is an idea, first and foremost. It's an idea. And today we have to decide whether this idea is about conquest or about defeat. Thank you very much for listening.